Hello everyone, I am Mrs. Ashwini Oak, working as a physics teacher at Ferguson College, Pune. In the last lecture, we had started with the conditions for constructive and destructive interference. Let us continue the same topic. We will see the details with the help of PowerPoint presentation. So we have started conditions for constructive interference in the last lecture. Let us continue with the same. We have the experimental setup of Young's double slit experiment. It is a cross section of experimental setup. And we are considering a point P on the screen, which is at distance Y from the central right point. If point P is the point due to constructive interference, then the crest of the wave emitted by S1 should overlap with the crest of the wave emitted by S2, or should overlap the crest trough of the wave by S2. We can see here in the second diagram. When the crest of two waves overlap, the point obtained on the screen is the point due to constructive interference, or when the troughs of the two waves overlap, the point is the point due to constructive interference. So it is the bright point obtained on the screen. So for the constructive interference to take place at point P, the path difference between the two waves, which is delta L, should be equal to lambda, 2 lambda, 3 lambda, 4 lambda, and so on. In general, we can write the path difference delta L for nth bright fringe as equal to yn into d by d, where yn is the distance of nth bright fringe from the central bright point. And that path difference should be equal to n lambda, or it is integral multiple of wavelength lambda, where n takes the values 0, plus minus 1, plus minus 2, plus minus 3, and so on. Here, plus minus sign denotes that the fringes are lying the either side of central bright point. If n is positive integer, then the fringes are on the upper side of central bright point. And if n is the negative integer, the fringes are on the lower side of central bright point. Now here, if n is equal to 0, that means the path difference delta L between the two waves is equal to 0. If path difference between the two waves is 0, then the point obtained on the screen is the central bright point O dash. If n is equal to 1, then the path difference between two waves delta L is equal to lambda. So it is the first bright point obtained on the screen on either side of central bright point. If n is equal to 2, then the path difference between the two waves is 2 lambda. So it is the second bright point on the screen on either side of central bright point. This is how we get the positions of different bright fringes on the screen. Now from this, we can write the equation for the distance of nth bright fringe, which is yn, equal to n lambda capital D by small d. So the distance of the bright fringe is directly proportional to the wavelength of light used. It is directly proportional to the distance between the slit and the screen, and it is inversely proportional to the distance between the two slits. So the distance of any nth bright fringe from the central bright fringe is n lambda capital D by small d. So we have seen the condition for path difference for the constructive interference. Let us see the condition for the phase difference between the two waves for the constructive interference. Now, when we consider the path difference between the two waves as a lambda, The phase difference between the two waves, which is denoted by delta phi, should be equal to 2 pi. When the path is lambda, the phase changes by 2 pi. So when path difference is lambda, phase difference is 2 pi. So at point P, for the constructive interference to take place, the phase difference delta phi should be equal to 2 pi or 4 pi or 6 pi and so on. That means when path difference is lambda, the phase difference is 2 pi. When path difference is 2 lambda, the phase difference is 4 pi. When path difference is 3 lambda, the phase difference is 6 pi and so on. So in general, we can write the condition for the phase difference between the two waves for nth bright fringe is equal to 2 pi n, where n is an integer. So n is equal to 0 plus minus 1 plus minus 2 and so on. If n is equal to 0, that means the phase difference between the two waves is 0 and we get the central bright point on the screen. If n is equal to 1, then the phase difference between the two waves is 2 pi. So we get the first bright fringe on the screen from the central bright fringe, and it is on either side of the central bright fringe. When n is equal to 2, then phase difference is 4 pi. So we get the second bright fringe on either side of central bright fringe. So this is the condition for the phase difference between the two waves for constructive interference. Now let us go for the conditions for destructive interference. Again, we take point P on the screen. So at point P, if the destructive interference takes place, that means the crest of one wave overlaps with the trough of the other wave and vice versa. You can see this in the second diagram. The crest of one wave overlaps with the trough of the other, or it is the trough of first wave overlaps with the crest of the other. In this case, the point obtained on the screen is the point due to destructive interference, or it is the dark point obtained on the screen. For this dark point at P, the path difference between the two waves delta L should be equal to lambda by 2 or 3 lambda by 2 or 5 lambda by 2 or 7 lambda by 2 and so on. So in general, we can write the path difference between the waves for nth dark point from the central bright point as yn(d) by d, where yn is the distance of nth dark point from the central bright point. And that should be equal to n minus half into lambda. From this conditions, lambda by 2, 3 lambda by 2, we get the general condition as n minus half into lambda, where n takes the values plus minus 1, plus minus 2, plus minus 3 and so on. Again, here plus minus sign indicates that the fringes are lying on the either side of central bright fringe. For positive sign, the fringes are on upper side of central bright fringe, and for negative sign, the fringes are on lower side of central bright fringe. So if we take the value of n, which is equal to 1, then 1 minus, so this is how we can obtain the equation for the distance of nth dark point from the central bright point. Now let us obtain the condition for phase difference for the destructive interference. When path difference between the two waves is lambda by 2, which is the first case for destructive interference, the phase difference between the two waves delta phi is pi. When path difference is lambda, the phase changes by 2 pi. When path difference is lambda by 2, the phase changes by pi. So phase difference is pi when the path difference is lambda by 2. So at point P, for the destructive interference to take place, delta phi, the phase difference, should be equal to pi, 3 pi, 5 pi and so on. So in general, we can write delta phi n, which is the phase difference between the two waves for nth dark point, is equal to n minus half into 2 pi, where n takes the values plus minus 1, plus minus 2, and so on. So when n is equal to 1, we get 1 minus half into 2 pi, which is equal to pi. So phase difference is pi. We get the first dark point from the central bright point. When n is equal to 2, then 2 minus half into 2 pi. So the phase difference becomes 3 pi, and we get the second dark point from the central bright point. And this goes on for 5 pi, 7 pi, and so on. So this is the general condition for the destructive interference to take place. Now let us see what is the fringe width, or what is the width of the fringes obtained on the screen. The distance between any two successive bright or any two successive dark fringes is called the fringe width. Now let us understand this with the help of the diagram. We are considering two successive bright fringes. The distance between the centers of two successive bright fringes is called as fringe width. Or if we consider two successive dark fringes, then the distance between the centers of two successive dark fringes is called as fringe width, and it is denoted by W. So fringe width W is equal to the distance between two consecutive bright or dark fringes, and therefore it is written as delta Y. We are taking two fringes. The distance of first fringe is yn, the distance of the second fringe is yn plus 1. So yn is the distance of nth fringe from the central bright fringe, and yn plus 1 is the distance of n plus 1th fringe from the central bright fringe. The difference between these two distances is nothing but our fringe width delta Y or W. Now let us obtain the fringe width for bright fringes. For bright fringes, Yn can be written as n lambda capital D by small d, and Yn plus 1 is written as n plus 1 lambda capital D by small d. So delta Y becomes n plus 1 lambda capital D by small d minus n lambda capital D by small d for bright fringes. After subtracting this, we get W is equal to lambda capital D by small d. So this is the fringe width for bright fringes. W is equal to lambda capital D by small d. Now let us find the fringe width for the dark fringes. So Yn is the distance of nth dark fringe from the central bright fringe, and Yn plus 1 is the distance of n plus 1th dark fringe from the central bright fringe. So Yn can be written as n minus half into lambda d by d, which can also be written as 2n minus 1 by 2 lambda d by d, and Yn plus 1 can be written as 2n plus 1 minus 1 lambda capital D by 2d. By solving this, we get the fringe width W is equal to lambda capital D by small d for dark fringes. So from these two equations, we can see that the fringe width for bright and dark fringes is same. So we can say that both bright and dark fringes are equidistant and they have equal widths. And from the above equation, we can see that the fringe width W is directly proportional to the wavelength of light used. It is directly proportional to capital D, the distance between the slits and the screen, and it is inversely proportional to the distance between the two slits, small d. So this is how we get the fringe width for bright and dark fringes, and we can conclude that these fringes are equidistant and they have equal widths. Now, when we get interference pattern consisting of bright and dark fringes on the screen, how is the intensity distributed in bright and dark fringes? So let us see the intensity distribution in the interference pattern. We have taken the same diagram of experimental setup, and now we are taking the central bright point O dash. So the waves from S1 and S2 cover the equal distance to reach point O dash on the screen. So the paths of the two waves emitted by S1 and S2 are same, and therefore we can write S1 O dash is equal to S2 O dash. Now the wave emitted by S1 can be represented in terms of its electric field. So the light wave from S1 is written as E1, which is the magnitude of its electric field, equal to E0 sin omega t, where E0 is the amplitude of the wave and sin omega t is the phase of the wave. For the second wave emitted by S2, when it reaches point O dash, the wave from S2 is represented with the help of its electric field, which is E2. So the magnitude of electric field of the second wave, E2, is equal to again E0 sin omega t. E0 is the amplitude, omega t is the phase. We can see here that both the waves emitted by S1 and S2 have the same amplitudes and they are in phase. They have the same phases. Now from these two equations, we can write down that the intensity of light wave is directly proportional to the square of amplitude, and therefore the intensity of individual wave, which is I0, is proportional to E0 square. When these two waves reach point O dash on the screen, the resultant electric field at point O dash is written as E is equal to E1 plus E2. Now substituting E1 and E2, we get E is equal to E0 sin omega t plus E0 sin omega t, that is equal to 2E0 sin omega t. Now here the amplitude of electric field is 2E0, and therefore the intensity of the wave at point O dash I is directly proportional to the square of amplitude, which is 2E0 whole square. So intensity at O dash is directly proportional to 4E0 square. But E0 square is proportional to I0, and therefore we can write I is equal to 4I0. Or the intensity at the bright point is equal to 4 times the intensity due to individual light wave. And this is the case for all bright fringes obtained on the screen. We can see this with the help of this representation. Here, the bright and dark fringes are shown. The intensity is plotted along y-axis, and the phases are plotted along x-axis. When the phase difference between the two waves is 0, we get the central bright fringe. And other bright fringes are obtained at phase difference 2 pi, 4 pi on either side of central bright fringe. Dark fringes are obtained when the phase difference is pi or 3 pi or 5 pi on either side of central bright fringe. If we see the intensity of the bright fringes at the center of all bright fringes, the intensity is maximum, and that is equal to 4I0. So at the center of a bright fringe, the intensity of a wave is 4 times the intensity of the incident wave, which is 4I0. If we see the centers of dark fringes, at the center of the dark fringes, the intensity is 0. You can see the intensity is 0 here in the graphical representation for dark fringes. And at in-between points, the intensity gradually changes from 0 to 4I0 and vice versa. That means from the center of central bright fringe to the center of first dark fringe, the intensity goes on decreasing, and from the center of the dark fringe to center of bright fringe, the intensity again goes on increasing. So it gradually changes from 0 to 4 I naught and vice versa. So from this we can conclude that the interference fringes are equally bright. All the fringes have same intensity, so they are equally bright and they are equally spaced. Now, if the point obtained on the screen is not the center of the bright fringe or it is not the center of the dark fringe, then what is the intensity at that point? That means if there exists a phase difference phi between the two waves when they arrive certain point on the screen, then what is the intensity at that point? Let us see. Now we are considering point P on the screen. So at point P, the waves from S1 and S2 arrive. So their paths S1P and S2P. We write the wave from S1 in terms of its electric field. So magnitude of electric field originated from S1 is E1, which is equal to E naught sine omega t. Here again, E naught is the amplitude and omega t is the phase. If we take the second wave originated from S2, then it is represented with its electric field E2 is equal to E naught sine omega t plus phi, where E naught is the amplitude and omega t plus phi is the phase of the wave. So here the phase difference between these two waves from S1 and S2 is nothing but phi. Now here the intensity which is incident at point P is I naught is equal to amplitude of the wave square. So I naught is equal to E naught square. It is the intensity of individual wave. But when these two waves from S1 and S2 arrive at point P, then the resultant electric field at point P can be written as E is equal to E1 plus E2. Substituting the values of E1 and E2, we get E is equal to E naught sine omega t plus E naught sine omega t plus phi. That is equal to E naught sine omega t plus E naught sine omega t cos phi plus cos omega t sine phi. We take E naught sine omega t common and in the bracket we get 1 plus cos phi plus E naught cos omega t sine phi. 1 plus cos phi can be written as 2 cos square phi by 2, and sine phi from the second term can be written as 2 sine phi by 2 cos phi by 2. And therefore E is equal to E naught sine omega t 2 cos square phi by 2 plus E naught cos omega t 2 sine phi by 2 cos phi by 2. Now from these two terms, 2 E naught cos phi by 2 is common. In the bracket we get sine omega t cos phi by 2 plus cos omega t sine phi by 2. And this can be written as equal to E naught cos phi by 2 into sine omega t plus phi by 2. Omega t plus phi by 2 is the phase and the amplitude of the wave is 2 E naught cos phi by 2. Now intensity at point P is always the square of the amplitude. So intensity at PI is equal to 4 E naught square cos square phi by 2. Now E naught square is nothing but I naught, and therefore we can write I is equal to 4 I naught cos square phi by 2. So if at a point there exists a phase difference phi between the two waves, then the intensity at that point I is equal to 4 I naught cos square phi by 2. Now, if we take the value of phi is equal to 0, if phi is 0, that means the phase difference between the two waves is 0, then it becomes I is equal to 4I naught cos square 0, cos 0 is 1, so I is equal to 4I naught. That means when the phase difference between the two waves is 0, the intensity at that point is 4I naught, which should be the bright point obtained on the screen. If we consider the case where phi, the phase difference between the two waves is 180 degree, then intensity at that point is I is equal to 4I naught cos square 180 by 2, that is cos square 90, cos 90 is 0, and therefore the intensity at that point is equal to 0. That means when the phase difference between the two waves is 180 degree or pi, then the intensity at that point is 0. The point obtained on the screen is the dark point. And if there exists a phase difference which is phi between the two waves, then the intensity at that point will be 4I naught cos square phi by 2. In this lecture, we have seen the positions of bright and dark fringes, the fringe width of bright and dark fringes, and intensity distribution in the interference pattern. You revise the topics from the textbook. We will meet in our next lecture. Thank you.